take me back to when you started. Why and what was kind of running through your mind at that time?
Well, I just thought the school I worked at needed a place to grow food, and I wanted a place for the children to come to and learn how to do that.
It's a relaxing place, but it's also a place you can just think of other things and get on and do like work.
And it's just such a release from school, from, you know, all the exams, especially being in year 11. It's such a good way to release your stress and just calm down and have a good start to the day.
I started coming, doing whatever I could, tidying the green container or greenhouse or whatever, making cups of tea on a Saturday. And then I found that actually I wanted to be here because it was a space then for me.
It's an absolutely fantastic place to come. At the end of a week, I always come down on a Friday, and it's just chill time. There's so many different things that occur here, so many different skills that I can use and practice and learn as well.
It is a unique thing. I've never seen anything like it, and it truly is totally inclusive. There is not a student at this school who is not entirely welcome down here, and there's not a student at the school who can't find a place down here.
What it's done for the school is more than I ever imagined it would do. What's now happened is that it has just blossomed in every way possible, and it's just provided much more for children than I ever planned out. I originally thought it would just be a small growing area, but now it's also become a place of escapism.
We've had the recycled knife and forks and stuff at school, and we've had horse muck that's been donated, and it's homegrown, like it's fresh and everything. It's not like Tesco's, but all the eggs are laid fresh each day, and like all the tomatoes are being used and strawberries, and it's quite inspiring.
Then it goes up to the school canteen, so you know where it came from, and it's all organic, all hand done.
You know, this whole the allotment project is all about setting an example, so we wanted to continue that at the school, and we have worked to dramatically improve how the school recycles itself, plastic bottles and waste and stuff like that. And again, it's sort of I think the allotment project has helped that to also be successful, I think, but it's all about the positive energy that this place has created.
I've learned all of these aspects to what plants prefer, what conditions they prefer, all of these little extra bits of knowledge that I didn't have before, I've learned since being down here at the allotment.
So many different types of children and young people come down, and it's not just about one. I could not give you a typical child that comes down here because there are so many different types of children that come down, and again, that has really helped with the ethos of the site, that it is all for everybody. It's not just for one type of child, it's for everybody, and everybody can come here and do something that is for them, and they can find something for them and play a part in what is now very much a community project for the school.
So just the practicalities of seasons, of how you can harvest water, just the practicality of doing it. I've always thought it's a good idea, but then how do you actually do it, and how do you get kids to be able to do it, and how can you get kids engaged in that?
Sometimes the raw material is better than having something that's you know, already made. You don't have to have everything that's brand new. It's not about brands, it's not about slogans, it's about being, you know, learning to make stuff, to build stuff. You can't learn that in a lesson, you have to learn that outdoors, and I think the allotment is the best way to do it.
You'd like to think your school is at the heart of the community, you'd like to think things go on in school where you really connect to community, but that's actually easily said and difficult to do. This does that, this ticks all those boxes, this absolutely is a community project and links the school to the community fantastically well.
The project has really evolved because of members of the local community. Local people just bring things to the project. All manner of things: time, kindness, understanding, wisdom, cups of tea, very nice cakes. And you know, it sometimes I have been on my own with this project at the very beginning, and it isn't until other adults from the community have come in and have appreciated what we as a team of young people have done and have really helped to evolve our project even more than before. We live in this world where nowadays everything is instantaneous and we get it when we want, and I think that's very harmful and I think that's not sustainable. The modern world, in my opinion, is like a freight train that's going on a railway. Everything seems to have to go at such a fast rate, and I think that's harmful. I think that's very bad, and I think eventually that train will derail. I worry in my lifetime that children will lose the connection with nature because of technology and television, and sort of I'm not sort of too looking forward to the culture that we're creating for the next generation, I think. And I think this place is to remind them of that we are part of nature, and that to work with it means that we can achieve beautiful things.
For me, it's a kind of complete clear headspace space where I don't have to think about anything else. I can come. There's no control freak in it. There's no, this is my project, it's this is your project.
Obviously, a lot of things that take place in school and college are inside, but it's something that actually says to you, right, let's go down to the allotment and get outside, and that's fantastic. Being in the fresh air, in the sun, it really does brighten up your day.
And I think the main objective of this allotment is to just care for nature, not, you know, sit around in circles singing Kumbaya, but really working together to look after the planet we live on.
Down here, it's not like just about your grades. Like, it doesn't matter if you've got like an A in science or something down here. Like, we all work together, and I think that's what's made us so special, because we've all worked together and it's now starting to grow and get bigger.
Question, as you know, we're expecting a heat wave this week, and I think most gardeners are wondering what on earth they're going to do. Any advice for Mr. Willer?
Water everything and try to have a team of children to help you. So,
sound advice, thanks ever so much.
You're welcome, thank you very much.